Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Selenix Crypto. I hope you're all doing great and welcome to an update on the render. Wanted to do an update because I covered this not too long ago, I think on Friday or Saturday, I think on Friday or Thursday even, not sure. But I covered this not too long ago. I know a lot of you still from the render community are around Selenix Crypto. And it's, I think the market situation right now is just very interesting. So I like to talk about it and hopefully then also add some value to your life or at least to your trading life / investing life. But all right, so we'll talk about render. We'll talk about what's going on right now, just in general, the situation in my eyes. And then we'll talk about the technicals. All right, so that's what we'll do. Before we dive into that, I do want to briefly mention that I have my own premium trading group in which I share my own trades as signals, but you also gain access to my trading guide and a chat room full of traders, which might be the most valuable thing out there. But for now, let's get into render. All right, so what we're seeing in general with this uptrend that started at the beginning of September, I always felt that it was a bit manipulated. Like, and we talked about that last time around as well, and that is that the volume back then, or the volume when this whole rally started, became way higher than it was before that, and also just significantly higher over a longer period of time. And what we're seeing right now, one of the indications of more bearish momentum is that the volume has dropped down. But apart from that, also a lot of the volume where it came from manipulated sources, all right, or at least sources which have a history of manipulation. And now what we're seeing as well is that the open interest is dropping down since Thursday when we hit our top. Volume is dropping down massively here. So what I'm trying to kind of point towards is the start of more bearish momentum for render. And that's what I expect. We were very, very bullish. I must say that that's also what I said in my last video. All right, in my last video, I said, even though render was still quite bullish, that I expected it to not break above this level and drop down. So I might be a little bit biased that I just want to be right. I'm sorry. But technically, like I said, all of those things we named are actually bearish indications. And what we're seeing right now as well is that the EMAs are flipping, especially the 28 and the 50 EMA are turning into resistance. Then we had a minor bearish breakout / bearish confirmation by breaking down below this level right here around 1.58 cents. So render is now finding support at a major support level, the 200 EMA plus a very strong trend line. It's also not getting that much support from that, so that's another bearish confirmation. So in my eyes, render looks bearish now, and I think we have reversed. It's still like it's a bit risky to say that because usually with manipulation, and perhaps we can still see it right now. Yeah, still a lot of volume comes from Top Credit, for example, or Bitunix and CoinTiger, which usually if a lot of volume comes from there, it's usually manipulated. So it's still possible with manipulation. A lot of things are possible. Purely technically, I would say we're bearish right now. The main thing is will render be able to break above $1.58? If it is able to do that, then we'll at least get back up towards 1.63, 1.65, and we'll try to break above that. But if it's not able to do that quickly, like in the next 24 hours or so, then I think that's enough bearish confirmation to assume that render will drop down below this major support around 1.54 and continue dropping down towards the levels right here around 1.48, 1.5, and ultimately I expect it to drop down even lower. So those are my that's what I think the most likely scenario is from here. Personally, I'm not shorting yet unless 1.53, 1.54 breaks. Just so you know, I wouldn't short right now. For now, I would wait for confirmation because we are at a significant support level. But it does look like more bearish momentum will come. Long term, render still a great project. Short term, doesn't look so great. That's my take on render. Thank you for watching. Take care and bye.